This is Mission Control Houston. The crew of Expedition 32 is busy today working on board the International Space Station on quite a number of different research experiments in a variety of different fields. They're also getting ready for a few different visiting vehicle activities, namely the arrival of the Japanese HTV-3, which will occur tomorrow morning. That spacecraft launched from the Japanese launch site at Tanegashima last week. It has spent the last several days closing in on the International Space Station, and it will arrive in the vicinity later on tonight and into the early morning hours tomorrow. We will have live coverage here on NASA TV beginning at 6 a.m. Central Time, 7 a.m. Eastern Time. Joe Acaba will be the one that will be reaching out and grabbing onto that large, huge cargo craft with the station's robotic arm. He'll be backed up by Aki Hoshide. After that takes place, Aki himself will take over and we'll bring it on in toward the International Space Station and get ready to install it to the bottom side of the Harmony node. This cargo craft is bringing up more than 4 tons of supplies to the Expedition 32 crew. After it gets secured to the station, the crews will, on the next day, open it up and get ready to begin unloading all of the cargo that is inside that pressurized section. So both Acaba and Aki Hoshide, as well as Sonny Williams, who will be backing them up, are going over final procedures today, taking a look at everything, making sure their skills are sharp and ready to go for tomorrow. Acaba is also going to be installing the centerline berthing camera today, which will go inside the hatchway in between Harmony and where HTV will arrive. This is basically a bird's eye view that will allow him to take a look basically straight down at the cargo craft as it nears the space station to make sure that everything is aligned and ready to go. He's also going to be calibrating the station's external cameras, which will help he and Aki as they take a look at this vehicle. They'll be inside the cupola, which gives them a pretty unique vantage point of this cargo craft as it comes up toward the station. But of course, all those different cameras outside the station are important as well. Meanwhile, Sonny Williams is busy loading up the Advanced Biological Research System payload application on the Express 2 laptop computer, which is part of one of the Express racks there. That ABRS is basically a locker-sized experiment facility that the crews can use to grow plants or house different sorts of insects and bugs to take a look at how things grow and react to being up in space. She also just wrapped up a ham radio pass with the Virginia Air and Space Museum up in Hampton, Virginia, where she talked with the people there about life in space, her previous time aboard the station, and what the crew has been up to since she arrived with Yuri Malenchenko and Aki Hoshide here just a few days ago. She's also going to be transferring some data from the acoustic dosimeters to one of the station's laptop computers to downlink that down to the ground. Those dosimeters take a look at the acoustic environment inside the station to make sure that there's not too much noise for the crew. Aki Hoshide himself is also performing some medical experiments. He's also taking a look, as we mentioned, at the HTV robotics procedures. He's also got some crew orientation time today, basically just getting used to his surroundings on board the station since he just arrived a few days ago. Even though he, as well as Sonny Williams and Yuri Malenchenko, are veterans of the space station, things change quite rapidly on board in terms of where things are stored and also the layout. So they spend a few hours after they get up there basically just getting used to their new home. The crew also had earlier today an emergency drill for fire. As we've talked about before, they train for 3 main different scenarios, fire being one of them, a toxic environment being number 2, and a depressurization being number 3. So they ran through that fire drill with their different ground teams around the world. And then after that was done, they had a quick chat with the teams here to talk about how it went. And the team here in Mission Control also had a talk amongst themselves to make sure that there's no improvements and any sort of way that they could smooth out that process each time they learn something new. So again, tomorrow morning, 6 a.m. Central Time, 7 a.m. Eastern Time, that is when we'll have live coverage of the arrival of the Japanese HTV cargo craft as it closes in on the International Space Station. That crew will be installing that tomorrow, and of course we'll have live coverage of all of that here on NASA television.